Hello, Sonny. So, do you like it here?
No, nothing happens here.
Well, that's not true. Have you ever heard the story of Team McClean?
No.
Well, they're just the most courageous men to ever walk the face of this city. It all started with one man, Don McClean, American hero. King me.
Thank you, thank you. Please, be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here tonight to honor a man, and not just your average man. The man we are here tonight to honor is a great man, an honorable man, a heroic man, an attractive man. We gather tonight to show our debt of gratitude to a man who, through his bravery and somewhat questionable tactics, has saved the world from certain doom no less than four times. That man I speak of is, of course, Don McClean. Don McClean graduated from the academy at the ripe age of 22, and for the last 26 years, without asking why or who or how many times should I shoot him, has put his balls right on the front line for this country. And it's only fitting that we honor him in such a prestigious way. So without further ado, let me introduce to you the man who proves that the ends really do justify the means. Ladies, he's single. Everyone, please join me in welcoming Don McClean. Don, get up here, you courageous son of a bitch!
Thank you all, and thank you, Reverend. That was a very nice introduction. I'm so glad you could all make it out here tonight, and I'd especially like to thank the new chief of police for making it out tonight. It's good to see him. Thank you. I'm sure I don't know most of you, but I'm sure you all know me, and it's with great humility that I join you here tonight. There's, of course, a few people I'd like to thank, people for without whom I would have had a difficult time becoming who I became to become. I'm not saying it wouldn't have happened, I'm just saying it would have been more difficult. Firstly and foremostly, I'd like to thank myself, of course, for without me, I would have probably been someone else. Maybe a tree or a hermaphrodite tortoise of some sort, I don't know. I'm not a doctor, but what I do know is this. I wouldn't have been Don McClean, and the world probably would have blown up years ago. So, thank you myself, and you're welcome. Secondly, I'd like to thank Lou Ferrigno for showing me what a real man is supposed to look like. I've spent years of my life sculpting this body by using Lou as a template, and as you can see, it's worked out for my better. So, thank you, Lou. But Lou's deaf. Thank you, Lou! And lastly, but not least, I'd like to thank my son, Donnie. And I'd like to say right here in front of God and everybody, Donnie, you inspire me, son. You've grown up from a good boy into a wonderful man and a great officer. An officer that I'm honored to now work side by side with. I'm so proud of you. They say that a man is only as good as his family, and if that is the case, then I am one wonderful man. All right, enough with the mush fest here. I was told there was going to be strippers. Is that over here? Is it? All right. Thank you. Go ahead and start the jacuzzi, honey. I'll be over in a little bit. No, the. Thank you. Hey, Dad. Hey, yeah. I just received a radio transmission from headquarters. I think maybe you and I should head out. Hey, this old telekey's not going to use itself, Donnie. Yeah, you know what? Totally sorry about that, but I think it's just something that only you and I can handle. You found the strippers? No, I didn't find the strippers, but there's a certain bad dude doing some bad dude things right now that I think maybe we should go check out. Not following you. Dad, ever tell you you're not very good with hints?
What are you trying to say?
Okay, I'm gonna pull the Fiero around front. Maybe you should meet me out there.
Where are we going, exactly?
I don't know, maybe go kill some bad guys, get some ice cream, maybe a candy apple.
Ah, excellent. All right, I'm with you. Shotgun! Dad, come in. Dad. Hello?
Dad! Dad! American hero, Don McClean.
This place, son?
Yeah, get low.
Is this the place, son?
Hide!
What?
Hide!
I just want to say, it's an honor working with you, Don McClean.
I know. All right. I'm going in.
No. This time, I'm going in.
You don't need to be the hero, son.
But you're one every day, Dad.
That's true.
I need to do this.
All right, Officer McClean. You move in. I got your back.
I know you do, Dad. All right. I'm going in.
Officer. But what the hell was that all about? I need to tell you something. See, I stumbled upon something at the precinct. You're the only one I can trust. What is it, son? It's bad. It goes all the way to the top.
No, son, no. No, this is my fault.
Dad.
No, don't talk, Donnie. Don't talk. I'm gonna go get some help. Don't move.
Desmond Grip Valley.
What? Donnie? Donnie, who's Desmond Grappelli? Donnie?
Donnie, who's Desmond Grappelli? No, son!
What'd you tell me? As if you knew no one was ever gonna find out, you still wouldn't do it.
No, I wouldn't sleep with Brad Pitt.
All right, okay. Too much, maybe. Would you spoon him?
Why do you guys do this?
What?
Every time we get together on a job, you make conversation all weird.
I just feel like we can talk to you, man.
Yeah, it's like we have this triangle friendship of trust.
No, we don't have a friend shape of any kind. As a matter of fact, we don't even exist. Now let's go. Are you coming? Hey, look. I'm sorry, that's pretty harsh. All right? Are we cool? Sorry about that, sir. We had to stop by his mom's house.
I hate it when you guys lie to me.
No, it's true. We had to stop by my mom's house.
I know you're lying. I just came from your mom's house.
Sorry, dude. Go to your happy place.
My mom's house was my happy place.
We have a problem, gentlemen. We need a solution. You see, there's an important event coming up soon, and I need a few fall guys, if you catch my drift.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I want you to find Don McClean.
Don McClean?
Yeah, no one's seen McClean in like 7 years.
I don't care. You go out there and you find him. And when you find him, give him this. Tell him that we need him to put together a task force for a special mission or something. I don't care. Just make sure he recruits these men.
Why these men?
These men are the only honest men left in this town with a hero complex. The only ones that might be foolish enough to get in the way. And with them out of the way, we'll own this place.
Sweet!
Tell him he's got a week to get this team together and wait for further instructions.
What if, this is hypothetical here, what if we're not able to find Don McClean?
Well, here's the deal. You don't find Don McClean, nobody's going to be able to find you. Are we clear?
Yes, sir.
A little grumpy today, huh?
Where the hell are we going to find Don McClean?
Yeah. American hero like that? Could be anywhere, doing anything. Could be plowing your wife right now.
Dude. First my mom, now my wife. You know, I'm sensitive about these kind of things, right?
Sorry, big guy. Does make you wonder, though.
About my mom?
No. About Don McClean. What's a legend like that doing these days?
Like that song, American Pie?
Yeah.
Not a bad song. I like it.
Well, it's okay, I guess, if you like that sort of thing.
Yeah. Bye, Miss American Pie.
Don McClean!
Exactly.
So stupid.
Try knocking again.
What?
Oh, jeez.
Hello. Don?
Listen, I told Vinny I'd have his money for him by Friday.
No, we're not here about that.
Who's Vinny?
My cousin.
Okay. You are Don McClean, right?
Who the hell are you guys?
That's not important. What is important is that you don't know us, but we know you.
you are Don McClean, right?
I'm afraid the Don McClean you're looking for no longer exists.
What the hell is he talking about? He's right there.
Dude, just let me handle this.
You're always handling everything.
Come on, this isn't the time.
Well, when is the time?
Well, certainly not right now.
Well, when?
Why do you have to be such a baby about this?
A baby about it? Great, look at you did.
What I did?
You!
Listen, we're gonna try this again. Just let me do the talking.
Fine.
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 Fine. Fine. Do something.
Baby.
What?
You can taste it.
Don, we have a very special mission for you.
I don't do that anymore.
That doesn't sound like the Don McClean we've heard of.
You've heard of the old Don McClean, the before Don McClean that was before the Don McClean that's currently before you right now.
Oh. Anyway, this is a very special mission for a very special man.
Well, I'm retarded.
Don't you mean you're tired?
What did I say?
You retarded?
He just won the gold medal and me kicking his ass. You want to try out for the silver?
Well, this train makes one stop and me kicking your ass central.
Oh, yeah? Does your train have a wet bar?
What?
Your train's got a wet bar. I'll make you a little cocktail, a little gin, maybe a little rum, a little me kicking your ass juice.
I have no desire to consume your ass juice.
Really?
Really.
You like Tang?
What?
Yeah. It's kind of like that.
Like Ford Mustang or like boom?
Whoa.
Oh, sorry, Gucci, you okay?
Can we just... Please.
Sorry.
Here's the mission. We need you to assemble a task force.
Is there evil afoot?
Yeah, sure, whatever. In this file is a list of men that my boss needs you to recruit. You have 1 week to do so, and then wait for further instructions.
What if I say no?
Are you a coward, Don McClean? Whoa, I'm just saying that, saying no wouldn't make Donnie very proud now, would it?
Does Donnie Osman have to do with any of this?
No, I'm talking about your son.
See you in a week, McClean.
Team McClean first. Dr. Magnus Marigold. Gadget guru. Today's the day you become a hero, Doc.
Right now.
Well, my gut's telling me. my guts never lied to me before. Ooh, honey buns. Tools. Okay. That, he's probably recruiting some of them losers right now.
You think so?
Oh, definitely do. Man like that, he's not gonna pass up an opportunity to reclaim his past glory.
Who's my guts?
Excuse me there, pretty lady.
Yes?
Am I in heaven, or do they just hire angels here?
Can I help you with something?
Don't we all need a little help with something?
I'm gonna call security.
Feisty, I like that. I'm Don McClean, American hero. I'm looking for a Dr. Marigold.
He's down the hall on the left.
Thank you. Maybe later tonight, I'll bring a box of wine, and you bring that sweet little ass, and you and I can constipate the relationship. What do you say? Put a perfume? Put a little perfume on there for me? Ah! Ah! I think this is it. I think, but I can't see anything. You're like Satan wisdom eyeballs. More like I can help you help me.
What?
May I come in?
Yeah.
Don't mind the mess. I've been trying to crossbreed a Cocker Spaniel with a nipple cactus.
How's that going for you?
Not too bad. You all right?
Yeah, I'm just a little sensitive to the cold weather and psycho receptionist. Do you have a tissue?
Tissue, yeah.
Thank you. Now, you are, you are Dr. Magnus Marigold, correct?
Yes, I am. I didn't catch your name?
Don McClean, American hero.
I believe I've heard of you.
I'm sure you have. What's this do exactly?
That's actually just a really, really big pen.
Oh.
Dr. Marigold, is this the elk earring you've been looking for? Oh my god, it's Don McClean!
Hello, hello, young man. How are you?
Mr. McClean, this is my assistant, Theodore.
My friends call me Fred.
That doesn't make any sense.
I love you.
Good. You.
I was the biggest Don McClean fan when I was just a little guy.
Thank you.
Huge fan. You have no idea.
Well, it's always nice to meet a fan.
Like this one time, me and my friend, my best friend, decided that he would be Batman for Halloween. Oh my god, this is so embarrassing. Okay, and that I would be Don McClean.
That's cool. Cool.
And he knew how excited I was to be Don McClean for Halloween. And you know what he did?
No, I don't.
He decided to dress up as Don McClean too, and he thought it'd be funny. And you know what?
What?
It wasn't funny. I can't believe I'm telling you this. Okay, so later that night, I drowned him in his pond in the backyard. Oh, crazy times.
Fred, why don't you go ahead and take your lunch right now?
Oh, okay.
Maybe take 2 hours instead
of the one. So nice to meet you, Mr. McClean. Freaking awesome, man.
Kids, tell ya.
You just let him roam freely?
Actually, no, we just installed an invisible fence a couple months ago.
Good.
We found that it's a lot more cost efficient when it comes to paying for background checks.
Yes. How's it work so far?
It's doing pretty good so far.
So, Don McClean, what brings you to my humble laboratory?
Well, you see, I've been chosen to put together a team of heroic men to combat a...
I'm sorry, you were saying?
I've been chosen to put together a team of heroic men to combat evil, undertake a mission, the details of which I don't even know yet. But I'm sure it has something to do with saving the world. Maybe even the entire planet Earth.
So what can I do for you?
Your presence on the team has been requested. We need a man of your gadget-making capabilities. Join the team and become a hero, Doc.
Can I maybe have a day or two to think about this?
No.
Okay, jeez. You know, sure, why not?
Superlative. My card. We'll be in touch. Everybody okay?
Yeah, everything's fine.
Good.
I wanted to let you know I won't let you down.
Right. No, on the paper!
Man, no. What I'm saying is that John Travolta was a better bad guy in Battlefield Earth than he was a bad guy in Broken Arrow.
Dude, you're crazy. For one, Battlefield Earth rocked.
Oh my god. I just don't know you anymore, man.
Yeah.
Hey, are you two cops?
Is he talking? Hey, kid, are you talking to us?
Yeah, you staked out in like the cop shows.
Hey, you know, why don't you and your little girlfriends there and your play with your Bratz dolls over in the street? Anyways. What I was saying, have you ever seen Raising Arizona?
Sorry, mister, I guess we're playing too hard in the street.
Oh, you little smart. Whoa, dude, wait. Take the high road, my friend. I mean, they're just a bunch of snot-nosed little punks.
That's it! No, dude. Whoa!
Hey, kid, you brought down the thunder.
Who says that anymore?
You heard me, little man.
I guess compared to you two, I am little.
Well, you know, I've been working on a little bit, but...
No, dude, it means you're fat!
That's it!
Dropped his cell phone.
Not so big now, are you, Fatto?
Oh, he's got a picture of your grandma on here.
Oh, sweet God! Nice!
Oh. Dude, you just got your ass kicked by a bunch of kids!
Dude, tell anybody about this.
Don't worry about it. Can you press this hoagie?
Dirk Longbarrel, huh? Badass name, I gotta give him that. 107th degree black belt. Bad seed, ex-cop. Once shot a man for breathing too loud. I'm lying about it. We're gonna get along just fine, Dirk Longbarrel. Excuse me, random civilian. Yes,
I'm looking to get my hands on a long barrel. Miss? Miss? Hey, hey, what is this, Russia? We don't talk to people anymore?
Why are communists always so sensitive? Make any sense?
Is Dirk the long barrel you're looking for?
What do you got? Come on. Gotta have more.
How's that going for you?
What the? Wait!
Why is Dirk running? Dirk eats fear and poos excellence.
Loves eagles,
especially that song, Hotel Dirkifornia. On a Dirk Desert Highway, cool wind in Dirk's hair, warm smell of Dirkaritas rising up through the air. Up ahead in the distance, Dirk saw shimmering light. Dirk's head grew heavy and Dirk's sight grew dim. Dirk had to stop for the night. Oh, look, a penny!
Dirk's had about enough of you.
Look at that. Yeah, there's another eagle over there. There's schools of them.
Dirk's not gonna fall for the...
Talk to me, Ghost.
What's your problem, muchacho?
You're not Dirk's ex-wife's lawyer?
No, I'm Don McClean, American hero.
Oh, sorry about that, man. Now, what can Dirk do for you?
You see, I've been chosen to put together a team of above-average men to combat, I'm guessing, some sort of evil. Probably save the world.
The whole world?
Well, not necessarily Buffalo, but most of it. And as I now know firsthand, sir, you have an above-par set of fighting skills.
Thank you.
You do. And if I could be frankly with you for a moment, I would be honored to have you on Team McClean. Are you down?
Like a one-legged Dirk at a roller derby.
Splendiferous. Let me get you my card.
Yeah,
there you are.
Julio's Ladies of the Night. Sorry, Dirk already has this one.
Sorry. Here you are. Here. We'll be in touch.
Dirk says that sounds good.
Okay. Real quick, one thing. Could I, trouble you for some ice, perhaps?
Oh, Dirk's sorry. Where's Dirk's manners? Well, let's go.
Why didn't you just open it?
This isn't Dirk's house.
Oh.
Everything's coming together nicely. Boss is gonna be pleased.
You know, I put on some eyeliner today. Is it noticeable?
Pretty noticeable.
It's kind of creepy.
Dude, it's all right. He didn't mean it. It looks fine.
See, you're sorry. Sorry, and it looks good.
Really?
Yeah, maybe next time use a little less, maybe a different shade, a little less maybe.
Beep, beep, beep. What the hell is this?
How's it going today, fellas?
Nothing. I mean, just enjoying a beautiful day, sir.
Licenses, please.
Why do you need all of them?
Licenses, please. Is he wearing eyeliner?
Did we do something wrong, officer?
Loitering is frowned upon in my neighborhood.
Oh, come on.
Get out of the car.
Dugan, eh? Used to be a cop, didn't you?
Yep.
I've heard of you. Grew up in this quiet little town. I like to keep it that way. You know what I mean? Why don't you get back in the car? I'm going to have to issue a ticket to you, gentlemen. Why don't you enjoy the day somewhere else? And I hope we don't see too much of each other.
Yes, sir.
Tango Foxtrot.
Unit 69 domestic and 412.
Ready for that, Sam.
That kid just signed his own death warrant.
Yeah, he could be like the perfect bait.
Is it really that noticeable?
Do you even own a mirror?
Hey man, thanks for the sausage and the vegetables.
Dirk just wants to let you know that Dirk is in.
Yeah, we already went over that. Well, I gotta get going. I got some hero things to do.
All right.
I'll see you around.
Alrighty. Pleasure was all Dirk's. Let Dirk know about the sausage.
Hey, that's my sun hat.
Uh-oh. Dirk better ditch it.
Von Scheisenhaus, expert marksman and hunter, 3.5 tours in Vietnam, 287 illegitimate children, accurate from 457 clicks away. Weapon of choice, laser Glock. The hell's a laser Glock? I guess this isn't so bad. You go to hell, Mother Nature. You go to hell.
Don McClean. I know why you were here.
You do?
Yes. You're here to give me a vacuum demonstration. But alas, I own none of your carpet technology.
No. No.
You are here to clean my pool, but alas, your bank demons seem to think they can repossess my pool.
No, that's not... How do you repossess a pool?
You are here to get directions to a place far away where your travels are taking you, but alas, your bank demons claim they own my GPS system.
No, actually, I'm putting together a team.
A team of champions?
Of heroes to combat evil, probably save...
The cheerleader.
The world. We could use a man of your abilities.
Does your team require background checks?
No, not really.
Excellent. Do that. Okay, John McClane, I am in.
Good. It's actually Don McClean, though. American hero.
It's pronounced Van Scheisenhaus.
I'm gonna go now, but we'll be in touch. We'll be in touch later. Good to have you aboard, Von Schisenhuser. We'll be in touch. That's just ridiculous. I trekked for miles, literally. Literally miles.
Actually, I have no idea where you went.
I walked for miles and days, and I had to eat an albino squirrel to maintain my stamina.
Albino squirrels are actually a myth. They're like Bigfoot or unicorn. Comfortable banana hammocks.
What the hell did I eat then?
Huh? Mister, have you seen my kitty?
No. No, I have not. Have you? Oh, he's good. He's good.
Mister, my feet are cold.
Sir, the team's assembled.
Excellent. What in God's name happened to you?
It was nothing.
He got beat up by a bunch of kids.
Dude, we talked about this.
Are you wearing eyeliner?
Ha ha!
You know what? Never mind. I don't want to know. Did you bring what I told you to bring me?
Yes, sir.
Chief, what are you doing here?
You made a mistake, Bobby.
I didn't know.
And now you do. That's the problem.
I won't tell anyone, I promise.
I wish that was good enough.
Oh God, what are you gonna do? No, please don't.
It's not me, Bobby. It's the system. It's corrupt. It's broken. You made a bad decision. The one thing about bad decisions is they need to be corrected.
Damn it, I'm a good cop.
Exactly. I don't care where you dump the body. Just do the kid a favor. Make him look like a hero.
Yes, sir. So I was telling Marcus that there's only so many of those double fudge chocolate mamas that you can eat in one sitting. But I was...
You guys got my Thin Mints?
Oh, McClean. Good job putting together that, the task force.
Do I know you?
Yeah, we met like the other day. I told you to put together a task force. You punched me in the face.
You see, I punch a lot of people in the face. You have to be a little more specific.
Oh, God. I gave you a folder, told you to put together a team. Evil's afoot.
Oh, right. Evil. Do you need something?
Yeah, a drink. Anyway, McLean, we need you to get the team together and meet at 2200 hours at the old warehouse on Lake Street.
2200 Lake Street, got it.
No, wait. No, it's 2200 hours on Lake Street.
2200 what?
It's 10 o'clock, Don.
Tonight?
Yes.
Okay, where exactly?
The old warehouse on Lake Street.
Is that the North Lake Street, the one down there? Or is that the other Lake Street?
No. There's only one Lake Street.
Says you.
Sir.
Yes?
Everything's ready.
Beautiful. Bye-bye, Don McClean.
For anything, gentlemen.
Dirk's got your back, man.
Let's do this!
Yeah. Hey, Doc, what is that?
Nice cue.
Alright, let's go. I thought there'd be another door here or something.
How do we get in?
Wait. I got this.
Nice.
Little room.
Oh, sure.
I don't want to kill and or maim anybody.
Found a door around the side of the building. Took that one.
Communication.
What the hell?
Man down. How is he?
He's gone. Dirk smells a setup. Who exactly did these orders come from?
Bunch of pussies!
Careful, I have sensitive wrists.
Oh, hey, boys, what's it been, like 6 months? Come on, grab a little tighter, man.
Boys got Dirk's room ready.
This place searched from top to bottom.
Yeah, boy.
Dirk is not watching your puzzle.
Dirk wants to know what the hell that was all about, McLean.
Hey, leave him alone. We shouldn't place all the blame on Don. should be split equally among you three.
Yeah, well, he's the one that got Dirk put in jail.
Dirk doesn't like jails.
Yeah, I'm not much of a fan myself. They remind me of college.
Where did you go to college?
Cuba.
Listen, I'm sorry, gentlemen, okay? This is my fault. It's my responsibility. I guess I was right. The old Don McClean just doesn't exist anymore.
Dirk agrees.
Guys, come on. We're a team now, okay? The only way we're gonna get out of this mess is to stick together.
Little Quirmo's right. We're being counterproductive. We're just jerking ourselves off here.
Dirk wouldn't say that too loudly in here if, Dirk were you.
Hello, Nancy's. Would you like to get out of here?
Who the hell's this guy? Who the hell are
Please.
You?
Please! Now's not the time to stop blindly trusting people. Okay, now, I know I have it here somewhere.
What cell number is this exactly?
It's 7B?
Yeah.
7B?
Yeah.
Just a second. No. What?
Nothing. Impressive.
All right, gentlemen. We must find a car. Something inconspicuous.
Why don't we just take my car? Which one is it? That white one right there, that's the McClean mobile.
Yeah.
That's what you call it? Seriously?
Yeah,
that's a stupid name.
You're a stupid name.
That's just shut up.
I guess we could just move all the soccer gear and all the groceries in the back. We should probably be able to cram in there.
What are you talking?
I'm just
that's
saying,
a man car.
Just
men drive those.
Just point it out.
The rear view mirror when you drive.
But you guys are a bunch of a-holes. Get in the car.
I call a shotgun.
A place to lay low for a while. Figure things out.
I actually got a spot we can stay at.
Is it a damn shoe?
Beautiful. You're beautiful.
No. Don, just turn left right here.
Right here.
So, you got a boat waiting for us?
Whoa. Dirk can't swim, man.
It's actually the lighthouse right there, guys.
I'm afraid you're off your rocker there, Doctor. I do not see a lighthouse. Oh, that lighthouse. Right. Yeah. Let's do this.
Hey, wait. My mom wants us to take our shoes off, too.
This. It's even smaller on the inside.
Yeah, how long do you expect us to hide out in this little room for, Doc?
Looks can be deceiving, gentlemen.
This is incredible, Doc.
I know. The way it looks this big is I bounce the sunlight off Jupiter's third moon and it comes back off the space station, and this is what you get.
You know, I don't know a lot about science, but I do enjoy the element of surprise.
You know, if I hadn't seen some crazy stuff in my life, I might have freaked out a little bit.
Yeah. What do you think, Dirk? Where's Dirk?
It's an obstacle illusion.
Gentlemen, please, take a seat. Don. Don, please, sit down. Thank you. Okay, gentlemen. If you'd like, please fill into the front.
We're good.
Okay. I would like to take this time to let you know who I am.
You know, before that, why don't you go ahead and tell us exactly who you are?
Well, if you'd like to put your big girl panties on, I was just about to get to that. There you go. Good boy.
Dirk likes this guy.
Actually, it's Mink.
Dirk doesn't speak Latin, dude.
What the hell are you talking about?
What the hell are you talking about?
What are you talking about? I asked you first.
Yeah, well then Dirk asked you.
No, but seriously.
Look, you want to do something about this?
Great. All right. Now we can get started.
I've got to pee really quick.
Sit down!
Dirk really likes this guy.
All right, gentlemen. My name is the Chameleon. I work for a secret government organization whose identity will remain anonymous at this time. You are all in very grave danger, more danger than even you realize. The man who you believe to be your chief of police is actually someone else, someone even more dangerous.
And that Mike Ditka?
No, it is not Mike Ditka.
Oh, I swear to God, it looks like Mike Ditka.
Well, it's not Mike Ditka.
Okay.
Because
it could be his brother or something.
It's not Mike Ditka.
Dirk's gonna go ahead and agree with the whole Ditka thing.
Would you like to do this? Would you like to come up here, do this, run the show, be the big boy?
No, actually,
Dirk doesn't understand what's going on with that whole magical voodoo box picture photography on the wall. Yeah.
Perhaps now would be a good time to start paying attention.
Right now?
Don, how do you put up with these morons?
Falafel Raptor, I found it. Yeah, right out. Done. You ready to start? If you're ready to start, you can go ahead and do that. We're ready. Go ahead. Ready.
This man's real name is Desmond Grappelli. He spent his whole life perfecting the art of murder and extortion.
Did you say Desmond Grappelli?
Yes. You've heard the name before?
Yeah. Long time ago.
He has the city by the Curly Shorts. He has left a trail of blood since hijacking the position. The men who recruited you are ex-cops with a violent history. Grappelli keeps them on his staff to do his dirty work. Their latest victim being a young officer by the name of Bobby McCullough. Bobby knew too much. Just like Donnie knew too much.
What are you talking about?
Where did you hear this name, Desmond Grappelli?
How did my son get wrapped up in all this?
We have information to believe that Donnie had uncovered the chief's true identity. We also have information to suggest that Grappelli had a hand in your son Donnie's death. Excuse me, gentlemen.
So, what did Dick do?
I'm sorry you had to find out this way.
I can't do this anymore, man, you know? I thought I could just jump back into being the old Don McClean, but I gotta tell you, I don't even know where he is now.
He's right here.
He's in my lapel?
Why don't I just talk for a while?
Yeah, all right.
You know, when I was a young boy, my father, he used to tell me stories of a great American hero named Don McClean. And how time and time again, he would look evil, square between the eye, and firmly place his boot up its buttock.
Yeah, I went through a lot of shoes.
Anyway, when I look into your eye, I see this great American hero. And I know that if you look hard enough, you also can find him and become the man who I grew up admiring. The man Donnie grew up admiring.
You're right. You know that? You're absolutely right. I'm out here feeling sorry for myself, and that son of a bitch is ruining my city. Excuse me. My foot has a date with his ass.
Wait. Not like this. I have a plan.
Yeah, I got a plan too. It's called TCB. Taking care of business.
Do you really want to get him?
I have to get him.
Well, my sources tell me that he will be announcing his candidacy for governorship tomorrow night at the policeman's ball.
We can't go to that.
Not as Team McClean, we cannot.
What are you talking about?
You're just going to have to trust me.
I want to thank you all for coming. This will be a brief statement and out of respect for those involved. No questions, please. Last night, on an anonymous tip, one of our own, a brave young officer with a promising future, Bobby McCullough, was found dead. I speak for the entire department when I say he will be truly missed. He died in the line of duty, doing what he loved most, protecting and serving his community. Because of the ongoing investigation, I'm unable to release any details at this time. I can tell you that the men we believe responsible are in custody at this time. And it's with a heavy heart I tell you one of the men in custody is Don McClean. Thank you.
Sure. Wait.
Wait a minute. Can you tell me?
Yes, 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 yes,
well, it's too bad McClean couldn't see that.
Well, actually, you see, T. McClean kind of escaped.
What? How could you let this happen?
I didn't.
Do you value your life?
Yes, sir.
Then you better find him.
Oh, okay.
They're fugitives now. Use any force necessary.
Yes, sir.
You better not do anything to mess this up, McClean.
Thanks, man. That was a good talk.
What is your team, McClean?
Sounds like they're up there somewhere.
Sure, they are ready for this.
Yeah, my team are complete professionals. I vouch for each and every one of them personally. It counts as like five men, you know what I mean? That's how much my
hands are. All right, gentlemen, here is the plan. Have any of you ever been incognito? Have any of you ever been undercover? Have any of you ever played dress up?
Oh, I love dress up. Yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
Kicks ass.
Good, good. Don, Scheisenhaus, you are in the band.
Nice.
Dirk, I have a lovely little black number for you to wear.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Dirk does not wear the little black number.
Well, if this plan is going to work, you're going to have to wear it.
Why don't you make Dirk wear it?
You're going to disrupt the plan.
Yeah, well, Dirk does not like this plan.
Nope. Someone's going to have to wear it.
What about that little guy right there?
What? That could work.
No, not happening, guys. I have a reputation to think about. Absolutely not. I'm putting my foot down on this. There's no way you guys are going to make me wear that exquisite little black number.
Grab this thing in my pants.
Excuse me?
It's a little device that will be more than a little handy tonight.
I don't know if I'm comfortable reaching into your pants.
Quit being a baby.
Now you're insulting me. You could have at least said please.
Will you please reach into my pants?
What am I grabbing exactly?
It's an audio recorder, fashioned to look like a cigar.
Why can't you just hand it to me?
Will you just grab it?
Hey, guys, I got...
Oh. Which pocket is it in?
It is in the left pocket. No, wait. Maybe the right. No, I was right. It is in the left.
Which one is it?
There is only one.
Sorry to intrude, gentlemen, but we're going to be the band tonight. So if you kids want to go ahead and pack it up and go play some Donkey Kong or some Red Rover or whatever it is you're doing now, that'd be great.
We're just the bus boys.
Yeah, I don't care what you call yourselves. We're the band tonight, so it's our gig. So why don't you move it along, all right?
No, we work here. We can't leave.
You can get smart. Okay, make this difficult. That's cool. You can do one of two things, okay? One, you can just leave. No one gets hurt. Nice and quiet, like. Or we can go with plan B.
What's plan B?
Dirk smash.
So when do you think we're going to get anything to eat?
I don't know. Seems like they're taking forever.
Right? Well, good evening.
Well, hello. What is this? My birthday?
How's everybody doing tonight?
Much better now, thanks.
Well, listen, as a thank you, the staff here wanted me to give you this complimentary cigar.
Why? Thanks, sweetie.
You guys have a good night.
You too. Yeah.
Still would like to have a salad.
But I could go on all night talking about how much this man has meant to our city. And in my eyes, there's no one that deserves this award more than the man I speak of. So without further ado, it is with my great pleasure that I introduce to you our Humanitarian of the Year, our very own Chief of Police, Chief Elliot Samuel.
Thank you all.
Hey, man, can I get a napkin? My wife spilled some water back there on the table. Hey, excuse me.
This is a great honor for
me. Hey, excuse me.
It has been an
absolute
privilege serving get you bent. And your family.
What did you say to me?
Serving all of you.
I said, get bent.
Oh, you are a bad waiter, all right? And I send you my damn napkin.
Only on a larger scale.
They're right behind you.
All right.
Now, for all of you who know me, you know that I'm not a man of many words. But I thought I would take this opportunity to make my big announcement. I wanted you folks to be the first to know my plans for running for governor for this great state. With your support, I will clean up this state much like I've cleaned up this town.
Hope everyone's ready to party. I'd like to introduce one of the hottest bands in the country, Buster Hyman and the Penetrators.
Woo!
Huh. I'll help everybody wear the rock pants tonight, because that's what we're gonna do, rocking your pants.
Right.
Sweet.
Hello all you cool cats and sexy ladies. Grab that one that's next to you, the one you love. Get on the floor and cut a rug, alright. Baby, I'm like a fire hose. Turn me on and then watch me explode. And when I get that feeling, I don't even want you near me. This is how love goes. This is how it's supposed to be. The funny thing about you, girl, I don't even need you around to be happy. Girl, don't get me wrong, I need you in my life. But sooner or later you'll have to decide, is it really worth the fight?
Any sign of McClean yet?
No, sir, but Marcus and Gunther are on it.
The time is of the essence.
Yes, sir.
Well, why don't you go ahead and get out of here? And we'll get things ready for later.
Yes, sir.
The funny thing about you, girl, I don't even need you around to be happy.
Okay, you kids stay cool.
Trumpet, huh? Hey, wake up. Wake up. Hey, there you go. How you feeling? You got a headache? Bit of hurts, doesn't it? Yeah, it sucks. Yeah.
Ah! You're not very systematic, are you?
Actually, my mother was Swedish.
You're lucky you're the muscle.
Ah! What are you doing?
He's friggin' hitting on me!
Guys, come on. That's enough. So let me handle this, alright?
All right. Fine.
Thank you. Some situations do not call for violence. Call for reason. Now listen, fella. Can I call you fella? I'm gonna call you fella. Seems to me you're not in the best of predicaments right now. So the best thing for you to do is let us know what we want to know. And we can go home, get out of here. What do you say?
Whoa. Dirk wants to know what the hell's going on here.
This.
Oh, yeah?
A bunch of jackasses.
Whoa. Dirk's had about enough of this guy. Why don't you answer some questions for old Dirk?
Who's Dirk?
Dirk's Dirk.
What?
Dirk's asking the questions here.
So who's Dirk exactly?
Are you being smart with Dirk?
I don't know.
Oh, you're playing games with Dirk. It's alright, Dirk likes little games.
So you are Dirk?
That's Mr. Dirk, scum nuts!
Mr. Dirk?
What?
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 You're trying to mess with Dirk's mind! Too bad for you, that's the only muscle Dirk doesn't use.
So you are Dirk?
Well, you're not Dirk, are you?
Maybe?
Okay. Well, I think that's about enough of that. Thank you, Dirk.
Dirk abides.
I think me and my new friend here are going to need some time alone.
Weird!
What do you guys think he's doing to him down there?
You know, there are things that happen in this world that you're just better off not knowing about, Doc.
He's right.
Yeah. Dirk was a prisoner once. They did bad things to Dirk. Unmentionably bad things.
Bet they hit you in the head a lot, didn't they?
No, but they did hit Dirk in the head a lot.
It shows.
Thank you. You know, sometimes Dirk still blacks out every now and again, probably from all the... Dirk?
Papa Bear?
What?
What, he said he wants us all to start calling him Papa Bear.
No, I believe that's just you.
Son of a bitch.
Whoa. That was a good one.
I believe I have everything we need on this recorder. I'm going to take it to the chief, see what he thinks.
I'll go.
Don! You're going to need this.
Oh, yeah, probably.
And Don! Try not to kill anyone.
Can't promise anything.
You okay, Dirk? You okay, Papa Bear?
Dirk's cool, Goldilocks.
What? What? You got something?
Give me good news.
Everything's coming together nice, Chief. Just got one more thing to pick up.
Excellent. Any sign of McClean?
Well, word on the street says McClean has bailed out of Dodge City.
Smart man. He just better keep his nose out of our business.
You mean you don't have any fries?
Dude, see, they got any hot dogs. I really want a hot dog.
What was that?
How am I supposed to have a burger without the freaking fries? It says, right here, satisfaction guaranteed.
Actually, sir, you put that sign there?
Don't change the subject, Deli Boy!
And you spelled satisfaction wrong.
I want some freaking fries now!
Well, I guess I have to be going now.
Well, stop by my office before you pick up that package.
Alrighty, will do. Alright.
Wow.
Dude, what the hell? Where's my hot dog?
I don't care if you have to go to flippin' Idaho, I want some mother flippin' fries
dude,
now!
Dude, chill!
Now! What, dude?
Nice chair you have here, Desmond. What's it made out of? Dead puppies, balsa wood, and hatred?
What did you call me?
Aw, don't tell me after all these years of shoveling your lies, you've actually forgotten your real name.
Do you know what I do with people who know too much?
Actually, I do. And actually, we know everything now. You see, one of your trusted men told us all we needed to know.
You have no idea who you're messing with.
No, I do. I just told you that.
Don't play games with me, McClean.
No games. You see, you're through playing games. In fact, you're through, period. Exclamation.
Are you serious?
Well, there was that time in prison, but that's why they call him Smokes.
Hey, boss! You found McClean! Are we, interrupting something?
Dude, I watched Raising Arizona. You were right. Excellent film.
Don't the baby's just the cutest, though?
Dude, game face.
Sorry.
Sorry, Don.
He's got a hard forehead, that's for sure.
So, boss, you want us to take care of him?
No, we've got things to do. Besides, I got someone special to take care of this piece of crap for me. You know what to do.
I see you work out.
I'll just go out the window.
Hey. Don McClean, American hero. Nice to... Don McClean. American hero.
Found the duck.
Oh.
Every time.
How's it for a mongoose? Hello?
Who is it? It's Don.
Hello?
Don? Don, hello? Can you hear me? Don!
What is it?
I hear lots of stuff falling and heavy breathing?
Go.
Don!
Duck, can you trace this?
I'm on it.
Here, you try.
Don? Hello? Hold on. We are coming.
Got it.
Maybe didn't hear who I was exactly. But I was saying.
Okay, I'm only gonna warn you one time, buddy, and then that's gonna be about the end of you. You're. You are making a big mistake. Big mistake.
Should be right here.
Yeah.
Enough? You had enough, sir.
Oh, hey, man. Thanks. Thanks for the help. You know, I think maybe you and me got off on the wrong foot. You know what I mean? I don't think there's any need for us to be fighting and... Okay. I'm so sorry about that, dude.
MapQuest lied, they lied.
You know, if the bank demons wouldn't have taken my GPS system, none of this would have happened.
Yeah, I really am.
There he is.
Hey, guys. One over.
Now. The real fun begins.
I do not like you.
Hey, buddy.
My friend wants to tussle.
Shoot him! Come on! Wait for
him!
Did you shoot him?
I shot him.
Yeah, he shot him.
Good. Wait, no, wait, oh!
Oh.
Okay. Yeah. Man. A tough little guy. Reminds me of a hooker from Tulsa I used to shack up with.
Yeah.
Kind of looks like her, too.
Yeah, Dirk needs the three S's right now. Sex, a sandwich, and a cigarette.
I think cigarette starts with a C.
What? Did you name Don Webster? No, it's Don McClean. That's right. Yeah.
Well, we better get going, guys. We got a world to save. Yeah. Janitor, look at this.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks.
What the hell happened to you guys?
Where's our little stool pigeon at?
He's still in the back. Why? What happened?
Think you're pretty clever, huh? Pretty smart? Smart guy? Is that what you think?
Shh.
Bullshit time's over there, cowboy. You gonna tell me everything I wanna know,
and you got about 3.5 minutes to do it. Go.
Something like a little bitch. It was great.
What's the plan?
Meet me in the public auditorium in about 57 minutes.
His name was Rico. He wore a diamond. Man, I'm so excited. I can't believe we're actually getting a room together.
Not getting a room. On the plan.
Oh, we're kidnapping the governor.
Shh. Say it a little louder, would you?
Sorry, man. I'm so excited.
Yeah, me too.
Excuse me.
What?
How you doing? We were just wondering if, you could let us know what room the governor's staying in.
Nope.
Oh, come on.
Huge fans. Huge fans. We just want to get his autograph and maybe fire up some ballpark franks.
I'm not allowed to give out that information.
You know, they plump when you cook them.
Come on, pretty lady.
Plump when you cook them.
We're not going to tell anybody. What do you say?
Plump.
I do have one thing you guys might like.
Ooh, I bet you do.
Does it plump? Yeah, that doesn't plump.
I told you this would happen if you got in the pool with me. Now you know why they call me the Lovener.
What the hell? That chick is like Marco Kidder crazy.
God, you said a mouthful there, brother. Now what?
I don't know. I was sure that was going to work.
Well, you think if we just grabbed some random dude, he'd notice?
Yeah, I think he'd notice.
You sure we can't grab some random guy? Because that guy looks a lot like him.
What the hell are you talking about?
Guy right there.
Hey, this one's mine, and this one is yours. So you just go ahead and take him. Go ahead.
Oh my God, it's him.
Where's his security detail? Where's his Secret Service at?
I don't know, maybe today's our lucky day.
Is that a ballpark Frank?
It is our lucky day.
It is our lucky day.
Just be with me and hold me. That's all I need. Just you and me.
Hello, Governor. Who are you guys? I was told I would be in here alone.
Catapult.
No way. The nice lady said I could swim here as long as I wanted to.
Nice lady? Just get out of the
pool. Nope.
Listen. I'm only gonna say this one more time. Get out of the pool.
Nope.
Get out of the pool!
Do this twice.
Shut up! Get out of the pool!
Three times.
Oh, you almost got me there. Go ahead, go ahead.
Oh, come on.
You almost got me. Go ahead. Come on.
Get little more, little more.
Oh, there you go.
A little further, just a little.
Grab my shirt collar.
Good, good.
How about the rubber duck? Can you reach him? Good.
Careful, dude.
Get out of the pool!
Get out of the pool!
Get out! What you doing? Get out of the pool!
Not the duck.
You want the duck? I want the duck.
I'll
bet you want
the duck.
I want that duck.
I bet you do. I bet he wants some hot dog.
I mean the duck.
Oh, you want the duck?
That is my duck.
It's okay. He's gonna be fine.
What the duck? You'll never get away with this.
You're
no,
about
that. It's a damn good hot dog. Go,
the
duck, baby.
It's not a duck.
dinner's on me tonight, boy.
Now what?
Hello, Governor.
What's going on here? Wait a minute. Aren't you the chief of police of this little... Where am I?
Well, for now.
For now? What's that supposed to mean?
Well, this is just something I'm doing to keep myself busy till I take your job.
My job? You've all lost your tiny little minds.
I think you better sit down, Governor.
Where am I?
This just happens to be the place that you're gonna do me a little favor.
A little favor? What do you want? Money? Candy? Hootie and the Blowfish tickets?
You can get us Hootie and the Blowfish tickets?
Oh yeah, I can get you anything you want. But please don't kill me.
Hootie, the Blowfish.
Governor, we're not gonna kill you.
You're not?
No.
Well, then what?
I just brought you here so that you'd understand who's going to win the election next fall. And it's not going to be you. As a matter of fact, tomorrow night in this very room, you're going to make it very crystal clear to the entire world that you're not even going to run for re-election and that you're going to endorse me. And then you're going to keep your mouth shut. Or maybe we'll shut it for you. You see, sometimes I get a little angry. And when I get angry, I do things. Bad things. Things I might even regret. And you flapping your gums and ruining the election for me, well, let's just say that wouldn't make me very happy. And I don't think you want to see that.
Are you threatening me? Just who the hell do you think you are?
Now you're going to be a tough guy, huh? Well, I'm not going to let you spoil this night. This is a good night. Good night for me, maybe not for you. It's just too bad there's nobody left in. Stupid enough to try to save you.
Sure, Don. Climbing the ductwork. Good idea. Could have probably gone in the back way. But you know what? You're here. You're committed. So let's just see it through.
You're in over your head, Chief. You know, people like me don't just go away. You're almost as stupid as he looks.
Edward.
What?
You know, you should really think before you speak.
Who's that?
It's your wife.
Not my wife.
Hey, can I get a sandwich?
You son of a... Get back, Governor!
Now, I said I wasn't gonna kill you. I didn't say I wasn't gonna kill anyone.
You'll never get away with this.
Oh, but I already have. And with you out of the way, no one will oppose my candidacy for governor. And the beautiful thing of it all is they'll blame McClean and his band of merry incompetents.
You underestimate McClean. He's more man than anyone can handle.
How fair.
Wait, what happened here?
Sounds like the missus had a little bit of McLeaning.
Lucy, you've got some splaining to do.
It was college. I was a bit adventurous.
What? You think someone's gonna fall out of the sky and save you?
This thing sure wobbles a lot.
Worse.
my God.
Fine.
Did you get the rest of that 33 cheese lasagna I sent you?
I did. It was delicious. Awesome. Yeah, thank you.
No, no problem, no problem.
I can't let you do this.
Perfect timing as usual. Wrong place. Perfect time.
Or is it that I'm at the perfect place at the wrong time?
And as usual, you're making absolutely no sense.
I'm just saying, my timing is impeachable.
No, you mean impeccable.
Thank you. It's very splendiferous of you to say that.
No, I mean what I... What?
Okay, boss, I think I got this one. See, what he's trying to say... I'm gonna get it now.
You ain't going to Hootie.
You guys are going to Hootie?
Yeah, I got an extra ticket now. You want to go?
Yeah, that's
nice. All right. Holy crap! Did you really like that lasagna recipe?
Yeah, I loved it. And the cottage cheese was in.
Oh, did you make with the French rolls and the garlic and stuff?
It's good. Yeah.
As I was saying, you're here just in time to see my plan become governor. Who knows, maybe work my way up through the ranks. Maybe even president of the United States. Who knows? The unfortunate thing for you is that once the authorities learn that I discovered your plan to kidnap the governor, shoot him and his wife. I hurried here as quickly as I could. Unfortunately, not in time to save them. But I was able to stop you. And when I take the gun, this gun, from your cold, dead hand, Trace will show.
Hey, boss, who's Trace?
Trace will find that this was the gun you used to shoot Donnie with. You were so caught up and being the best, that you had to get rid of the biggest threat to your reputation, your own son.
You're sick! Guys, help! Right now!
You want some gum?
Come on in.
Laser Glock.
Sorry about this, dude.
Oh, me pebbles!
My son wanted me to give this to you.
You are in big, big trouble. Yeah, sorry. All Dirk hears is blah, blah, blah. Punch me!
You want to go?
Go where?
I mean, you want to fight?
I got 2 tickets to Hootie.
Hootie sucks.
Well, I can't fight you. Usually I just urinate myself and pass out.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know it.
Oh! Hello! Don McClean, remember?
Oh, Dirk, sorry.
gravy. Come on, guys, here we go. We got the Steve McClean number one. Let's go. Come on, down behind you. Oh, God, look out. All right, Dirk, shoot Chuck's coming at you. Take him. Don't need him, baby. Here we go. Come on, guys, come on. Nice, like that right there. Here we go. Listen up. No, he's got that. Oh, watch it, BS. Watch it.
Playtime's over, McClain. Tell Donnie I said hi.
Why don't you tell him yourself?
Ah! I'm a monster.
Do it! Kill me!
That's too good for you.
Guys, I can't say thank you enough. And as far as any of those charges against you, consider yourselves pardoned.
Wait a minute. So you're going to pardon us for everything that we've ever done?
Sure.
Sweet!
Sir, are you ready?
Yeah. Thanks to these guys. Not ready. Hey, wait a minute. I didn't get your names.
We're Team McClean, American heroes. Seriously?
Damn it.
Seriously, after all the crap we've been through, now this door's locked.
Shut up.
Dirk.
Hello, I got this.
And that's how Team McClean got started.
Wow, mister, is there more?
Oh, yes, there's lots more. Come back tomorrow and I'll tell you some more.
See you tomorrow.
Yes, lots more. Yes,
much, much more indeed.
The world is Don McClean. He be the hero, know what I mean. Keep alive all the hopes and American dreams. In a world of deceit isn't what it seems. This job is for crime fight kings. So call Team McClean, that's what it means. They don't know potatoes from a bag of beans. Looking in from the out ain't what it seems. When a case needs solved, yes, Don's the man. Funny like Bruce Willis and he has a plan. Can he manage to mess up? Hell yes, he can. But the man's full of pride, so he's taking a stand. Come to say the day is Don McClean. That's all, know what I mean. Don McClean, he can do the show to lean on. Team McClean, keep alive all the hopes and American dreams. Come to say the day is John McClean. That's all, know what I mean. John McClean, you can do the show to lean on. Team McClean, keep alive all the hopes and American dreams.
Superhero. Superhero.
Superhero, zero. He can't fly, no cake, no mask, bionic eye. Still, there ain't nothing that he won't try. Wanna be a diehard that you can't deny. Who called this fool, man? I don't know why. His Team McClean seems like idiot guys. They say the day to even their surprise. So being the emissary ain't a move is wise. Now McClean got hard, he is so brave. Until the crime's solved, he can't be hazed. The things he gets done, even he is amazed. He completes the mission and he won't be fazed.
Come to say the day is
John McClean.
That's all, know what I mean.
John McClean,
he can do the show to lean on.
Team McClean,
keep alive all the hopes and American dreams.
Hey guys, hey.
I told you everything I know. Hello?